now to talk about this is Florida Senator Marco Rubio, the son of Cuban immigrants. Senator, thanks for joining me. First, I want to ask about President-elect Donald Trump. He has called President Obama's move to normalize relations with Cuba a weak agreement, but in the past, he also expressed interest in opening a hotel in Cuba, saying it's okay to bring Cuba back into the fold. What will you be demanding of the Trump administration vis-a-vis Cuba?
Well, first of all, the thing you outline about Donald Trump happened a long time ago. He has since then said that that's not, they never went forward with it, and he has since changed his position. And we're always, like I said, for many people, Cuba is an issue they're not dealing with every single day unless you live down here in Miami. And so we're always looking to change people's minds on it. And since that time, as a candidate for president, he made very clear that he felt that the moves that President Obama had made towards Cuba were wrong, and that he would examine them and change the ones that needed to be changed. And I think that's very promising. So what I argue is, number one, our goal is the national security and national interest of the United States, and as part of that, to do everything possible through our foreign policy towards Cuba to incentivize and pave the way for the move towards democracy. So, and we should examine our policy towards Cuba through those lenses. And if there's a policy that helps that, it remains in place. And if it's a policy that doesn't, it's removed. And that's what I would encourage them to do, and I look forward to working with them on that.
So, Senator, just to be clear, do you feel confident that a president-elect Trump, when in office, will roll back the openings that President Obama put in place?
Well, I'll take him at his word for it. That's what he said he was going to do. And number two, I'm a lot more confident in him doing it than I would have been in Hillary Clinton doing it, which I'm sure she would not have. So again, we intend to play an active role in making suggestions and providing guidance about what we specifically think needs to happen. But so far, he has said all the right things. I know they've had good people advising them on this issue as well. So I certainly have confidence that he's going to do the right thing when it comes to Cuba.
Senator, you called President Obama pathetic for offering condolences to Fidel Castro's
Absolutely.
Family. But, you know, he wasn't the only world leader to do so. And even Pope Francis sent a telegram expressing sentiments of sorrow. As a practicing Catholic, what's your reaction to that?
Well, as a practicing Catholic, I believe in the theological authority of the Bishop of Rome, and that's what Pope Francis is. On political matters, however, particularly on foreign policy issues, I don't necessarily believe that that binds those of us in the faith in terms of issues of foreign policy. I still respect it, but that's a very different thing. Pope Francis is the leader of a religious organization, the Roman Catholic Church. Barack Obama is the president of the most powerful country in the world. And what I call pathetic is not mentioning whatsoever in that statement the reality that there are thousands upon thousands of people who suffered brutally under the Castro regime. He executed people. He jailed people for 20 to 30 years. The Florida Straits, there are thousands of people who lost their lives fleeing his dictatorship. And not to acknowledge any of that in the statement, I felt is pathetic. Absolutely.
Senator, I want to